Welcome to Late Night Chat with JT Nico, episode 251.
Red sky bleeding from my eyes. Tides rising up to new heights. I turn my back to the wind. Slowly drifting away. I hear the night. Welcome to your new.
Beats for 10 inches, I'm sending the blitz. Live on the toilet, I stay on my shit. You say we us, but you stay on my dick. My shooter a rapper, I send them a hit. They be on Twitter like, when he gon' miss? Say I fell off, but I fell in this bitch. Fuck your white flag, I ain't telling them shit. I play it cool and hand Brody the blick. Got your stew just to show you I'm rich. Now you can't drop no new music or shit. How you jump right on that song and then snitch? Nigga, you sassy and wrong as a bitch. Say the wrong thing and get put on that list. This is a warning, cause savage don't diss. Better thank me that your ass still exists. Cause Jesus can't save you from West Indies stick. She don't look good without
makeup on. That intro threw you, eh? You didn't know what that was at the start.
I was like, what is this? Love making music right now, bro? And then it reminded me of just like 10 minutes ago when I was burning my ass on fire on the toilet bed. I live on the toilet too, though.
Yeah, of course. And in the car. You go from the toilet to the car. Love,
yeah, that's it, man.
Love making music, bro. You're in the car. I thought, we get we cozy on up here and another episode.
Isn't that JT Savage?
Yeah, that's 21 Savage with his new album. Red Sky is the name of that song.
I mean, don't get me wrong, the intro sounded okay. It sounded, but I mean, I wasn't expecting the hip hop to drop like that.
Yeah, that's what makes it sick.
Yeah, bet, man. Yeah, so speaking of sick.
Yeah. How you feeling?
Oh, a lot better today, bro. A lot better, man.
That's good.
I could breathe again.
That's good.
That's always a good thing, bro.
Yeah, breathing is usually important.
Hey, look who it is.
What's going on? Hold on. Before you get into football, because I'm sure that's what you want to get into here, because it is important to talk about that for sure.
Well, get the promos out of the way so we can fucking...
That's what I mean, yeah, because so we can get to discuss Wild Card Weekend here that just passed in football here. So Jay apparently was too sick to record yesterday. I think, guys, it's just because he wanted to watch those football games, quite honestly. I think that's what's going on. He didn't like my message after the game, though, when the Bucks won. I got no reply. I'm like, Bucks win. I sent him like a gift. No reply. Yeah, this guy's going to chalk it up to I was sleeping. Okay, we all know that's not true.
No, I wasn't, because I knew what it was. That's why I was like, no, I'm not like...
All right, well, let's get into some business here. So yeah, this is episode 251. We hope you guys all were able to check back and check out episode 250 with us. And if you didn't, if you missed out on that, that was a really fun time. Make sure to go back and check out that episode in the playlist there, guys. If you missed it, it was me, JT, and the ladies there. We got Julie and Leslie, of course. Yeah, for all the ladies. Rob, unfortunately, wasn't able to join us that day because of sickness. Again, hence this is time of the year, right? I mean, a lot of people getting sick. And then, and as I mentioned, Lewis wasn't able to join us as well. He's a new father, so he wasn't able to join us because it was basically, I think, that week after or whatever, of him giving birth.
Not him giving birth, yeah. Let's correct that. It's the wife giving birth. Yeah. He looks like he can give birth, but I mean...
I thought it was Immaculate Conception, or what they call it. I thought he's the one that gave birth. Is that what they call it? The baby just...
pops out. Falls from the sky.
That's right. The stork dropped them off. No, so yeah, congratulations to them again. But yeah, that's why they weren't able to join us in the last episode. So we're a couple of hosts short, but that happens sometimes on those episodes. But make sure to go check that out. It was a lot of fun. We played some games as we tend to do when we get together with each other. It also was a great, an hour and a half at least of conversation prior to that part of the show. So if you weren't live in the chat, maybe the game stuff wouldn't be as fun for you to go back and rewatch, but there's still a lot of great conversation before and afterwards, actually.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's a good episode. Shout out to everybody that tuned in for that and that joined us that day. Thank you to the other hosts. And yeah, this is a whole new era 5 years in. We also celebrated our 5-year anniversary of doing the late night chat stuff, guys. We're 5 years into this this thing here. So yeah.
Holy fuck, hey.
Yeah. And if you guys want to hear all the thousands of hours that we've wasted doing,
yeah, go back and listen to the show.
Because I pulled up some stats, some quick stats for you guys here. So between here and double duty over a late night collectors community, I've done over 1,000 hours apparently, according to these stats. Jay's just under 900, I think. So yeah, so you guys got to go back and check that out. That was a really fun episode. So, but yeah, the thing that
I was kind of dumbfounded, I was kind of dumbfounded, bro. I really couldn't believe that I actually sat there and did something for 800 and whatever hours it was.
Those were quick maths, though, Jay. It may have been more, it may have been less, but I'm pretty sure it's more. Those were quick maths. Quick maths.
Yeah. No, that's it. Yeah, that's just rounding it off to the nearest 10 or whatever, you know? Like,
yeah. Yeah, that was kind of just like I quickly was able to, like, you know, predict an approximate amount of time that each episode is and times it by how many episodes you're on, kind of thing, right? So, because, you know, let's be honest, in terms of the late night chat, I think Jay, you can count on one hand the episodes that he's missed for late night chat, honestly. So, but not much keeps him away, right? So, there's been a few times where I've had to step in, but even on those episodes, he's in the chat or he comes on for 2 minutes. So, like, you know,
yeah, like you. Where are you? You're just doing this. You're like, yeah, no, I needed a break. No, I always, it's always, unless I'm dying, bro, I yeah. And there's been a couple times, you know, during COVID, obviously, I think we all had a bout with not being able to make it one time or another, right? So.
Yeah, it happened. Coffee, actually, which I know is rare for me on the show, but yeah, ever since, you know, right now, ran that Costco run, I got some more K-cups or whatever the fuck they call them, right? So got some more of those cups that you can throw in the coffee maker here. So stocked up. So no, I'm tired.
Grab the box, 150, 200 or whatever. It's like, you know, you can go to Costco and get as many as you want, eh?
Yeah. No, it's you know, it's one of those days I just bit tired. I actually woke up from a nap prior to this show here too and ate dinner and jumped on. So it was nice to get started a little early here tonight, but I pulled an after work nap, which is rare for me, right? So I sacked out for a little bit. But
bro, you know what? You have to, man. There's certain times of the year you just have to, man.
Yeah.
Right.
But,
so.
But the thing I wanted to mention, and then we can kind of get into football here, is is the thing that we announced on episode 250 as well, is moving forward. Since we are 5 years into this thing, we're trying to, you know, work smarter, not harder for ourselves, and kind of make it more manageable for everybody involved to continue doing it. And, you know, give people like Jay and even me a break with these 1,000 hours that we put into this thing. And we're taking the show to bi-weekly episodes, guys. So it's going to be every 2 weeks. Yeah, no, that's right. Bi-weekly, no homo.
Every time I hear that, bro, sorry, it comes in.
Yeah, maybe for you this week.
Yeah. Fucking that's like, I'm with you, bro.
But we, so it's going to be every 2 weeks now. We are still going to be doing the live kind of format with the episodes. And everybody, all the hosts are still involved that were previously involved for now. But we are doing it every 2 weeks, which kind of limits, instead of 50 episodes a year or whatever we put out, it's going to be at 25. So you're going to get about 5 episodes with every host, you know, as long as they can show up for their weeks, you know, and Jay along with them. We'll see how that goes. But the incentive is going to be when we do these live shows, though, for the people that do still like to tune in live and watch us live, because I think in terms of overall participation of that, people tuning in for the live shows this past year, it's gone down a bit, we've noticed. And, you know, we're 5 years into this thing now, and we're trying to make it easier for folks involved. So it's not like a fucking, you know, part-time job over here with the content that we put into this. And, you know, kind of make it fun for us again, give us some more opportunities to kind of get together and do things in person and hopefully do other types of shows if we find the time and interest in doing so. That's kind of the idea behind it. So we're going to be, you know, the incentive will be if you want to tune in and watch these shows live and take part in the chat and that kind of thing, and you like that part of the show, which has become a big part of the show for the last couple of years. Make sure to follow us on Instagram. One of two things: follow us on Instagram at Late Night Chat Network on Instagram, because that'll be the most up to date kind of updates where we put out the message to let you guys know this tonight's the episode at this time. Make sure to tune in, or hit the little notification bell on YouTube underneath this video, guys. And by hitting that bell, it'll kind of give you an update to your YouTube account. It'll come up on your phone as a notification, like so many things on your phone, like does over on your YouTube app. And it'll kind of let you know when we are going live. And that's two good ways of kind of keeping track of when the show goes live or when the show is going to be scheduled for. Because moving forward, we'll have our assigned weeks, but it doesn't also necessarily mean we're going to be here recording on Monday. Like, it's Tuesday today, for example, right? We couldn't make Monday work yesterday. So again, we're just trying to make it more manageable for us. But again, if you are around when we do the live show, yeah, feel free to tune in as always, right? It'll be every 2 weeks. So if you get the opportunity to come in and check us live in the chat, hit us up, you know, come chat in the chat. It's always a good time. Otherwise, you won't see us for another 2 weeks. Now, the good thing about that, though, is if you don't tune in live, if you're one of these people that likes to catch us on the replay, you'll still have the opportunity to do that. But a day or two after the show actually airs, you'll get the first episode of two episodes that we're going to be splitting up amongst 2 weeks. So that means that we're going to be splitting the episodes in half that we put out live, and to kind of keep our numbers up and keep weekly content coming out for you guys, you'll get half of the episode 1 week, and then the next week, the other half of the episode, they'll air live, but they'll air live, but we won't be live when those air. So if you guys do want to watch us live and make sure to check us out before, and you don't have to wait a week or two to get the whole episode, That's your incentive to check us out live. If not, if you're one of these people who likes to see us on the replay, you're going to get an episode each week still. It's just going to be, you know, more manageable, like a 45 minute to an hour episode. So that's good too for the people that don't want to sit here and watch a 2 hour episode plus a 2 hour, you know, 2 hour episode for us, because normally we go an hour and a half, 2 hours, and you know, and so you're going to start seeing changes like that going on, guys. So, you know, I think it's going to be good for everybody moving forward. And I think even for you guys, because let's be honest, even me, when I watch these shows on YouTube or podcasts and stuff like that, episodes that are that long, it's not really manageable in the sense of your, you know, day to day to kind of sit there and be listening to something for 2+ hours. Right. So we're going to try to make it a little easier for you guys to check out our episodes in that sense too. And if you're here to hang out and you want to come by the chat, you got that still going for you too. Just make sure to stay tuned. So, because it might, you know, we don't know what day and times they will air every week. It's not going to be consistent in that sense, right? So yeah, Jay, anything you want to say on that, or what's going on?
Yeah, there, man, what's up, Gore? I want people like that to go. I want people to maybe take a little bit more initiative if they want to be in the chat too, man. Come on, you can come on screen. I mean, you don't have to be a face. You can just be a picture. I mean, I don't know if I can do it right now with my camera right now, but it'd probably be a little bit hard to show you how it works, but there you go. Actually, it's not.
Yeah.
This is what you look like, but you don't have to have your face there, right? You can make up voices. You can fuck around with us, man, if you really want to, man. Yeah.
You can come by and kind of chat with us on screen, and you don't even, like you said,
look like me.
Yeah. All you guys that are camera shy, I got one here on mine too. All you guys that are camera shy, I mean, that's all you got to do, man. Look, here's one of mine.
I don't see it.
No, yeah. It didn't go up. Hold on. Hold up. But yeah, no, it's kind of cool when you can do this, right? Yeah, you got to turn your camera off. I forgot.
Yeah. Oh, or you can leave. But you know what? It's okay. When you leave, it's just me on here.
I put the wrong thing. There you go. Oh,
there he is.
You son of a bitch.
That's it. See?
I'll be back. There you go.
Because there is a lot of people out there. I'll be honest. There's a lot of people out there that are camera shy. Right?
Yeah, we never really showed this part of it. Like sometimes, like we had Lewis call in last episode, who wasn't able to join us, and he just called in via phone, but he had the picture up when he called in, right? That's what I mean. So for all you guys that have been camera shy,
breastfeeding,
yeah, that's right. His newborn, yeah. So for all you guys that are camera shy and, like, you know, have wanted to join us on screen, just want to come on here and chat or even call in, let's say, like I said, like Lewis did there apparently, but again, you got to just go in through the StreamYard link. Let us know, because, yeah, like Jay said, it'd be nice to kind of get some new people on here, chat with some new folks, mix it up a little bit, right? Because, you know, that's at this point in the game of doing this kind of stuff, it's just, you know, it's just for entertainment for us. So we definitely want to kind of keep it.
And for everybody.
Yeah, exactly. Keep people interested and have fun with it, right? So yeah, definitely let us know. Here, I got another one here. Let's see which one I got. Oh, look. Yeah, I got this one. I don't know why the fuck I got this one. Hey, what's going on? I got it on mine too, so there you go.
Yeah, you know what? If I really I could talk to myself, that'd be really cool, man. Isn't that kind of neat? I'm in actually the same spot. Different car, but the same spot, if you think about it. Mm-hmm. That was kind of funny. That's the old car, man.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. So, yeah, so there you go, guys. That'll be the only change moving forward. Like I said, you can still expect weekly shows to air live after the actual full live version goes out. But if you know, we encourage people to kind of
come. Well, I want to put it out there. I want to put it out there here as this. This is my, for the new year, this is my, what do you call it? Hopes for it. Because I challenge people on each person's show, okay, for the late night chat. And then who comes on more without a picture, or I mean like with the, like we just did, and you know, interacts that way, or vice versa, you know, like maybe even wants to come on with the chat. But I put it out there like, you know, who gets the most this year, and if at the end of the year I'm gonna see who had the most people pop on screen like that. And not those while I'm in the laundry room sort of fucking, you know, I'm in my laundry, I'm on the shitter, I'm sort of on those. It's not one of those. But I mean, anytime you want to just come on, you know, like, I want to see and challenge people, man, and see, like, you know, for each show. So it kind of gives me a different perspective of maybe who I'm dealing with in the chat during people's live shows, because there's a lot of live shows where I've seen a lot of names, never put faces or voices to any of them, right? And I don't need to necessarily put faces, but voices would be cool, kind of thing, right? And yeah, if you want to have an argument, we're always good to have an argument.
You can come on for like, you know, 10 minutes, 15 minutes. It doesn't have to be like you're on for the whole, you know, show. Yeah, so maybe at each episode when you're on here, maybe throw out the offer during the episode there, Jay, and kind of let people know, and then we can kind of send the link out to folks, as you need a special link to kind of jump on screen. Yeah. Regardless of you having a camera or not, right? So yeah, no, that's good. I like that, Jay. That's good that you're putting that out there, and I second that. I think that's a good thing to start up, and hopefully we can get some people to come join us that way, because I think you're right. Like, there's a lot of people that spend time talking in the chat, you know, mixing it up with us, but they don't join us on screen. And if it's because you're camera shy, you don't have a setup for it, you can literally jump on your phone with the link and then sign in, and then like Jay just did, put a picture up or no picture. It could be a picture where you don't have an avatar if you don't have it set up. Like, it just looks like this. It looks like an egg person here. Like, it's like that. And then whatever, just put your name in and then you just jump on, man. It's the easiest fucking thing in the world. And I think, like, you're right, we haven't really talked about it in so long. I think people forget that. Like, people forget that you can just do that if you want to come in. Like, you know, it's our version of calling into the show, like first time, long time, like the radio show type shit, right? Just come on as a voice, right? Like, just come in as a person with a name and a voice. And if you're and that'll give you guys incentive to tune in live too, because the chat part of this is always fun for sure, but I think it's, you know, that's why you got to make sure to follow us to be up to date of when these shows are going to go out live now. That's all I'm saying, because it's going to be every 2 weeks. You guys are going to forget about me. I'm not on again for 10 weeks after this, right? That's what I mean with this bi-weekly schedule.
I won't forget about you. I promise.
No, but that's kind of how it is, right? That's how it is now with the new schedule, unless I kind of appear in the chat or even I jump on screen with you guys, like if you guys are chatting about something. That's kind of how it's going to be, right? And, you know, and you can also check us out still weekly every week at Thursday at 8 p.m., guys. I haven't been putting up the posts on the Instagram because it's just become like regular habit every week for it to go out. But Watching the Throne, me and Jay are still kind of we just started recording season 7, which will be out in a couple of weeks. But we've already banked a couple of episodes coming up already for the end of season 6. I think we have Kyle coming on back on as a guest, the finale of this season, as well as the first episode of season 7. So make sure to check that out. So you're going to have a couple of episodes with him coming up in the next couple of weeks as a guest joining us again. And yeah, we're close to the end here. It's 12 more episodes, I think, we have to record of that. And we're done with Game of Thrones. And I was looking.
I'm starting to get freaked out with it now, man, because now I went into the, trying to watch the third episode today, and I was just like, oh my God, this is interesting. Let's see who's aligning who with who, yeah. Right?
Yeah.
Because who's in it for their own good? It's fun. It's an interesting show, guys. I'll be honest with you, Nico, for thanking you afterwards for saying let's do this, because be honest with you, I didn't think I was going to like doing it, and I'm actually, fuck, bro. We're gonna keep telling everybody how much have I written. I've written novels, like I'm writing my own Game of Thrones book.
Yeah, you know? Plus it was the only way I feel like we could have really got you to talk in depth about a television show, because I know I pitched that idea to you before, but I said, why don't you go off and do this? Because there's literally everything you watch week to week, and you never kind of took yourself up on that offer of having to do that show. So this was one of the only ways to get JT to talk about TV, like on his own actual type of show, right? And
oh, I've been thinking about different shows and stuff like that now. Now you have me thinking about even other ones that are like kind of cool to pick apart. If you really like, because honestly, doing it like this and picking stuff apart like this, you start to realize, you know what? There's a lot of shows out there. Yeah, they might not have the fan base of a Game of Thrones or whatever, but they do have a following, obviously. They might not have a cult following as Game of Thrones, where, you know, they have web pages dedicated to this, right? And crazy people that dress up and know how to talk Valyrian. But, yeah, this is probably kind of cool. There is some other shows that I'm pretty sure people would be interested in figuring it out. So, following along.
Well, not only that, when we're done with Game of Thrones, guys, we already have plans to do House of the Dragon. And I already mapped it out, Jay. Watching the Throne show, if we continue with our weekly schedule, will be done by the end of April. That means that between May and June, July, because there may have been, there is no official date out as of yet, but there was a leak apparently, possibly by one of the actors. I guess he was asked about it this past day. And he said he thinks it's coming out in August, although it has not been confirmed. But that means, guys, honestly, by the time Watching the Throne is done, we have just enough time probably to put out this House of the Dragon show, which we're going to be talking about again, 10 episodes of that before the new season of House of the Dragon. So we're also putting it out there, guys. We're urging all the fans of Game of Thrones or people that are new to it, like Jay was last year with House of the Dragon, that do want to check out that show and come on and talk about it with us again. Yeah. No, we got a lot of interest in this new House of the Dragon season for people to join us. So let us know if you are.
Well, there's going to be fighting, man. I'm pretty sure there's going to be fighting for that one, man. That'll be awesome. We can put bids down, like, you know, let's make a bid.
It's exciting because we're going to actually be doing our first show where we're reviewing episode by episode of a new show in real time, essentially. Like, not in real time. We're going to be doing it a day or two after the episode airs. But the week of each episode will be coming on. And it'll be a different type of discussion because we're not going to be able to break it down with the full synopsis like we do now, because these are already shows that are out there, you know, been documented for years ago, right? So, like, it'll be a much different conversation. I'm really looking forward to doing that, like, week to week. That'll be a lot of fun, that House of the Dragon once that airs. And it's supposed to be coming this summer. So, yeah, make sure to tune in for that. But yeah. So, yeah, good stuff, guys, all around. And, yeah, just a happy five-year anniversary to us. Congrats, Jay. Honestly, it's been a lot of fun doing this. And thank you.
Myself on the back.
Yeah, thank you to everybody. You yeah, man. Thank you, everybody that's joined us along the way, the people that have helped us come on as a guest, or the friends that supported us or have tuned into the chat or have played, you know, the battles with us. Anybody who's involved is, you know, over at Late Night Collectors Community, too, all the people that we see on those shows, you know, Christine, Chris, you know, everybody that's helped us out along the way. So shout out to everybody. Thank you.
So, keeping them, yeah, because without them too, it wouldn't be the same. Trust me.
And you know, from here on out, I think, you know, since the 5 year mark, we'll see. You know, how long it goes on till the wheels fall off at this point, right? Because I think we've accomplished something in that sense. And you know, from here on out, you know, I don't really have any goals in mind other than to continue to have fun doing this with our friends and, you know, and making it more manageable for ourselves, like I said. So, yeah.
Good stuff. Nice.
Anyways, yeah, let's get into football here. The wild card weekend picks that just passed because very timely, of course, that we talked about.
I thought I had you, bro. I don't know why I went like that. I don't know why I picked the team, but no, you fucked me. And then You then got me again. You got me twice this weekend, bro.
I'm the second now out of the whole pool, which is surprising by 2 points.
Yeah, you fucking mind fucked me, you little fucker.
Let's get into it. Did you watch all the games, Jay? Did you end up watching them all, or?
I didn't watch them all. I missed the Green Bay one.
Okay, well, because I don't really catch many games, but like, I want to get your thoughts on some of these games here. So the first one in the pool that I went large on points for anybody that doesn't know that we're in a pool, but we've been talking about it, me and Rob and Jay here on the show. This first game, this is the one that fucked me real hard, is that the Houston-Cleveland game. And yeah, Jay stuck to his gun.
Houston is going, man. Like I said, the way they were playing all year, I've been watching the games.
Yeah.
And to be honest with you, I just like their style, man. I was like, I think they can take Cleveland. Cleveland was coming on strong in the end, but I like the way they were doing it, man. So I told you, I said, I'm going Houston. I'm going to stick with it, man, because I've been doing it. I've been riding them for the last little while.
Yeah, my boy Joe Flacco there on the Browns quarterback right now, which by the way, like, he's old, bro. Like, Flacco used to play for the Baltimore Ravens years ago, and I'm a Baltimore fan. So, and guess who's going on to face Baltimore next week, right? But it is Houston, all teams. So it's interesting, but you know. From what I saw some clips, Houston was looking good this game. They killed them like 45 to 14, bro. That's insane. Like 45 to 14. They blew them out.
Blowout and a half.
The only reason I went with the Browns, even though I was feeling Houston as well, is because of Flacco, because he has more playoff experience than the guy that's been playing for Houston. But they're on a run right now, man. They've won a lot of their last few games, right? So that's good for them. They won the wild card weekend and their opportunity to get in there to the playoffs, and they're facing Baltimore next week. So it'll be an interesting game to say the least, man. But
those are the two games I didn't see yet.
Yeah.
One and then the Green Bay and Dallas one. And I said, you know what? Jordan Love's been fucking riding this wave, man, too. And I'm like, you know what? I know how much everybody in that pool loves Dallas.
Smart. Yeah.
Right. And I said, you know what? I'm going to go Green Bay.
That's one of the only other things that saved me, because I missed out on big points on that game too, but not as big as everybody else. Now, I had the balls to go for the full 16 points in our pool on the Buffalo game now, which a lot of people, again, I'm surprised did not go for Buffalo, but given.
I went 15 points, bro.
No, there's no 15. There were 16 and 12, right? It's all four. Six, eight. It wasn't 15, because then this one there's only six games or whatever, right? Remember, it was 12, 14, 16. How many points did you take on that game?
The second highest one.
14 then. You took 14 then.
Okay.
Yeah. So, there we go. There's some compression on there on the board. So I took 16 points on that. That was another one I was surprised that. I mean, given the Bills' track record with getting in the playoffs, it being in the playoffs, they haven't really done so well there in that regard. So maybe that's what people were thinking. But I'm still surprised so many people didn't go with them. I mean, I get not maybe wanting to take the 16 points, because honestly, going into that game, I could have seen it going either way. But, at the end of the day, it's like I'm really happy I bet big on that one. And I didn't bet as big on the Dallas game, because I knew everyone was going to be going for Dallas. And I fucking hate Dallas. I'm so glad that they're out, bro. I hate that the Dallas Cowboys. They've had a good year, though. But again, they're one of those teams in the playoffs. I seen a meme I told you where it was just like, this is the one time a year that Leafs fans and fucking football fans are like, Leaf fans and fucking Cowboy fans are like the same in that regard, right? That's what they were trying to say in the meme that I saw. Because
they used to win a lot back in the day, from what I hear, right?
Of course, man.
They used to be a lot better, but not now, right? Now they've just been stinking it up.
I seen somebody like tweet out that Dak Prescott there. You're like on MLK Day of all days. This guy fucking got his ass kicked. It's because Martin Luther King Day they played on, right? So. Lions Rams was the only good game.
This game was a fucking insane game. I'm sorry. I he's right. I'm sorry. That game, man. I wanted the Lions to win so bad, bro. They had.
I took the Lions. Yeah, I took the Lions.
They had You know what's funny? They had Eminem, but you know, you have fucking Paul Rosenberg sticking his fat head and belly into every picture that he's in, every shot that he's in. It's hilarious, bro. Right? I just thought it was funny. Hey, what are you doing? We get off the ground. Go sit in a seat. Yeah. You know? But the thing about this game was
1 point win. Yeah. 24-23. Yeah. Yeah. 1 point.
Yeah, but that game, the one thing about that game there was what's his name? Was it Stafford from their quarterback for the Rams?
Matthew Stafford, yeah.
Yeah. I know how they switched. I was hearing how they switched spots as quarterbacks, right?
Yeah.
So the thing was, he had a cut hand from the week before, like a fucked up hand from the week before. And then the first couple of throws, he threw it and caught his hand on somebody's helmet. So he had this big gash in between his fingers. So they're trying to repair him on the, and it's his throwing hand too.
Right.
So they're trying to repair him on the sideline. All of a sudden, the guy's throwing better.
Right.
Right? They try to get the numbing down, like the swelling down or whatever, right? I don't know what they give them over there, bro. They must be giving him stuff, everybody stuff, because another guy was kicking the ball on one game with his hamstring fucking pulled and still making field goals and punts and stuff, those guys, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. But this guy was bleeding, and he started throwing a lot better, and there was this one kid on the Rams, a rookie, that was just making every catch. Dude, he was jumping up. And if I've ever seen anybody get twirled around, it was these guys. Like, he would jump up, catch the ball. Somebody would knock his feet. Then the other one knock him from the top. And they would do this, like, crazy acrobatic thing in the air before they fell. Mm-hmm. Oh, my God. What a fucking... Like, I fell for these guys. But they were loving it.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know who loves to get hit like that, bro.
I mean, listen, you know, you got to keep that adrenaline going or else you're going to be on the side. You're going to be taking out the game, right? I mean, yeah, I know, I hear what you're saying, but that's, you know, they got to get themselves hyped up for that kind of thing. But,
man, they get hit hard, man. Like, I mean, I couldn't believe it.
Sure.
I couldn't believe it, right? But yeah, that game was crazy.
I saw this. Yeah, it was a 30, it was 30 below in KC. And the craziest thing was the Bills, where they were playing, how much snow was in the stadium, they paid the fans $20 an hour the day before to go there and actually help shovel snow. Like, which honestly, if I was down there, that would have been a cool experience. Just, I mean, yeah, you're going to fuck
tailgate party and fucking snow moving.
Yeah. I mean, listen, if you're a diehard Bills fan, Bills Mafia, bro, those guys are crazy. Those fucking people, man.
They were sitting on snow mounds, bro.
Yeah. But that's what I mean. They're paying fans $20 an hour to go do that because, and I don't know if you watched, there were some clips, some videos I saw of like them trying to take all the snow out of the stands. Like, that's how packed in it
was. No way.
Yeah, it was nuts. It was nuts, man. It was just like all of them were just having a good time, it seemed like, doing it, right? Freezing their ass off. But hey, you know that they're there for their team, right? They're trying to help out. So good for them, man. Fucking shout out.
Those fucking nutcases from Buffalo can handle that, man. Like, really? They get dumped on every year though. I mean, that's nothing for them, right?
Yeah.
I mean, but that's no fun. And apparently they just got hit again, right? So they had a very small time window, a time frame where they could play a game.
Yeah.
And if they didn't get the people, because they still had to obviously have to, if they won, they had to play this week coming up. But they also have had a time period, like they had to do it in that day when it was like the calm before the storm, because there was another storm moving in. Right. Mm-hmm. So they get both sides of the storm, and what happens is when they get both sides of the storm,
yeah,
it kind of screws everything up, right? It kind of throws everything off. So,
right. This is the person I was actually speaking of, Joe, Jalen Hurts, not Dak Prescott. Yes. I messed up on who I said. They play
just recording right now. Yeah. Sorry. That was my landlord.
Okay. They're playing. They played on Martin Luther King Day. The Eagles, I believe. That's who I was referring to, is Jalen Hurts. Jalen Hurts got taken out by Baker Mayfield, which is fucking crazy. I don't know, man. That Eagles team really fell apart towards the end of it, like halfway through the season, it seemed like, this year. I don't know what was going on with them. I know a lot of diehard Eagle fans are really crushed right now, though, because obviously the way they started out the season was not how they ended it. And I know there's a lot of folks that were really disappointed by that, by Jalen Hurts and you know, the whole team, right? And I, you know, here I was thinking it was because they were plagued maybe by injuries, because like a lot of these other teams had them, but not even that's not even the case, right? So yeah, no, it's really disappointing, because honestly, that's why I'm not surprised that you know, people still bet as they did, like you did, Jay, for the Eagles, right? It went so hard for them, but like honestly, like I'm not big on the Bucks myself, right? But it's just the Eagles have not played a good defense, right?
At yeah.
Half, right? And KC, I'm surprised, pulled out the win too, honestly, the way they've been playing.
Yeah.
So
I gotta answer this guy, bro. Guys, I'm sorry, guys. Hold on 1 second.
Yeah. So yeah. Yeah, so it's you know, like I said, I wasn't able really to catch many of the games there. I was busy throughout the weekend, but I was following them. And I ended up having a good week in the pool. I mean, I lost big on the Browns game and the Cowboys. I didn't go as crazy with everybody else with the whole Cowboys bet that was made there. Because, again, I hate the Cowboys, so I'm happy to see them go out personally. But, you know, I know that there's a lot of Cowboy fans, as always, that are disappointed. But what's interesting is it's really shaping up to be a lot of the teams that I feel people didn't really – like expect to be in get past a wild card. What's that?
Even you.
If you want, deaf. If you want to go do your thing and chat.
Oh no, it's okay. It's okay. He's okay. He moved in the spot. He wanted to switch spots with me, but I get the best internet from here, so I'm taking this one tonight, buddy.
So, yeah. Be like, set up the Wi-Fi. Maybe I won't be out.
Yeah. So but, I'm good.
Yeah, but anyways, I was just saying, I know a lot of the teams that a lot of big upsets already at wild card weekend, honestly, like a lot of big upsets in that sense too. But it was nice to see teams like the Lions get through, honestly, like Jay was saying, Houston, that's been surprising.
Oh.
Like, yeah, so like it's good to see different teams make it into the playoffs and stuff like this, because like,
but without their quarterback, bro, I mean, he's the reason why they keep winning the game.
He's amazing.
He ran a touchdown too, man.
Josh Allen is sick, man. Like he's a good fucking quarterback, man.
Like, I hate Buffalo. Period. Like I don't like the state, like the city. You know.
Yeah, I agree. Some good football. Listen, you know, here's the thing. I don't like Buffalo either. It is the armpit of America, but it's the closest team we have to Canada. Like you got to remember that. Like honestly, like
I know they tried to get them to one time play their home games here, their snow games here.
Detroit too. There's Detroit too. Yeah, they did exhibition games here. Like I remember, I went to a Bills Steelers game. I think it was like years ago. I think it was the game against the Bills. It was Steelers for sure. I went as a Steelers fan. This is years ago, though. This is like 10 years ago or something, I think, that I went. They did an exhibition. Yeah. They were testing out the market here to see for a while if they could have football here, but then it just didn't end up happening, right? Like, I went to one of those exhibition games. It was a lot of fun. But, I mean, the way I look at it, there's a lot of people that are Bills fans here because, you know, again, they're close to Toronto. Like, that's the way I've always looked at it. But then, you know, I know folks that are over in Windsor, and they literally just drive over to Detroit from there, right? Because it's right fucking there. And they go to the Detroit games, right? So, like, it's, you know, and Detroit's another one of those teams that's been around, you know.
They have an indoor place. They have an indoor arena now, an indoor place now, don't they?
Yeah, well, they have that. I mean, it's not new now, but, like, there's, like, it was, like, several years. Is that the one where Eminem put that video out? Or, like, or is that gone now?
No, I think that was the one that was torn down, no?
That was the one that was torn down that he did that in, right? Yeah, okay, they have a new arena now, right?
Yeah, their arena is indoors. Like, there's nobody, you could not, I'm going, they're in Detroit and it's not cold. How is it not cold in Detroit, but it's cold everywhere else, right?
Right.
And I'm looking and they were saying because it was artificial turf, but these guys were coming out with bigger grass stains and shit like that than regular turf, you know what I mean? It was kind of funny that you were seeing that, right? Because I was wondering why nobody was. They said by the fourth quarter, people were getting hot, you know, down by probably on the field, and you know, I'm watching these guys that are getting oxygen fed to them through the fucking tank.
Yeah, I heard about
that. You know, like, it's crazy, man.
Yeah,
and I'm going, holy fuck.
Another crazy thing, too, is Belichick's gone, the coach. Bill Belichick, of course, who did not have a good season this year with the Patriots. But, like, that's a – I mean, you know.
Yeah, I mean, they might scoop him up somewhere else from what I've been hearing on the radio, right? Some of the other – one of the other teams might pick him up.
He's a great fucking coach, man. Hate him or love him. Like, that guy in Brady, the Brady years, he was the coach when Brady won all those fucking Super Bowls. Like, I mean, he's – you know, I know there's been – rumors over the years in terms of like his, you know, him cheating. There was a whole thing about people talking about how he like, you know, reads people's plays and shit like that. You know, it's, there's there's a lot of talk about where he's going to land. Let me tell you, cause he's not done, but he's done with the Patriots after this fucking season. And he's been playing the last few years without Tom Brady once he retired. Well, first he went to the Bucks and then he retired, but like, it's kind of end of an era, honestly, like in terms of like the Belichick Brady thing. You know, that he's not playing. Belichick's not fucking coaching that team. Like, all these Pats fans, man, this is an end of a fucking era. That, because Belichick was, like, the last part of that that team that was still there, you know, from the fucking glory days of all those wins that they got. Now that he's gone from there, you know, I guess we'll see what happens. But, yeah, I was hearing some theories about where he's going to land. Detroit was thrown out there. I heard somebody say maybe Detroit would pick him up. But
Let's see what their coach can do right now.
This is before the wild card weekend, what happened with Detroit.
Yeah, exactly. He just got them into the playoffs, right? So for the first time.
Because at the end of the regular season, that's when they said like he was done with the Patriots, right? So like,
yeah.
So like, that's when all these kind of theories were floating out there. Where is he going to end up? Whatever, right? So, yeah. Listen, I mean, I'm just saying, you can't deny that team in football. Like, you hate them or love them, like they won how many fucking Super Bowls together? Those two, Brady and Belichick, right? Listen, I'm not a fan of Boston either, as much as everybody likes to say I am. I'm really not like it, but you know.
The only thing I like from Boston is when they do those fake accents and they put them in like TV shows and stuff. You know, like those Boston accents, those Irish Boston. That's, you know. They always talk about it like that, but no, plus I don't like their hockey team.
Well, that's what I mean. Listen, between all the sports, they've won enough fucking things the last of a lifetime, the last 20 years, let's be honest, right? Between football,
hockey,
baseball, baseball. Hockey, yeah, exactly. That's enough now. The Celtics, like, come on.
Well, yeah, well, you forget about basketball because we don't follow it, yeah.
Basketball, the Celtics, like, come on, bro. Like, that's enough now. That's, you know. That's what I mean. They could go fuck themselves. I'm with Rob. Like,
I was dying, man.
Yeah. So, yeah. So it's an end of an era, though. It's very interesting in that sense. Right. But so, yeah, what are the games next week? Let's take a look at what's going on here. We got next week with the first playoffs games here. We got
Baltimore and Houston.
Yeah. Baltimore versus Houston, the Ravens versus the Texans. Then you got the 49ers versus the Packers. You got the Lions versus the Bucks. That'll be an interesting game.
Now, the 49ers and the Packers is like a lot of history there in that one too, no?
49ers? Yeah, that's a rivalry right there. That's a fucking that's a big rivalry right there.
That's going to be scary, man, to bet on too.
Yeah, and then you got the Bills and the Chiefs, which is a fucking huge game too, honestly. You know, that's a huge fucking game because – again, you're talking about Mahomes, who's kind of been a hothead this season. Honestly, he's kind of blew up. Yeah, he hasn't been having the best season. I think the team has been having some trouble with him. He's kind of blown up a couple of times at his teammates, which hasn't been a good look on him, honestly, because he seemed he's been humble in years past, but now this year he's had some. I think he's really getting pushed in terms of like his performance, like on the field. So I think it's. I don't think it's – I don't know. We'll see. I'm not going to let anything away. I'm not going to give any of my picks away. I'm just saying.
I don't know. It'll
before.
Be an interesting game to watch, right?
Made it farther in the playoffs than the Bills have in recent years. So let's just put it that way, right? So I took –
he's not going to run it like fucking Allen.
They took out the fucking Dolphins, okay? Listen, that's all
he's
I got.
A little pretty boy. Allen, apparently, compared to him, Allen will run through a fucking linebacker, bro, a centerman.
I'm a big Mahomes fan too, though, man. I am. I like KC a lot. But
I'd rather watch Buffalo win. I can't stand those guys in commercials of Mahomes and my auto. And fucking, then they add fucking their coach in there now, the one with the fucking booger mustache. frozen booger mustache that looked like a popsicle. He was going like this. Did you not notice during the game? He was going. It was like a booger popsicle, man.
I see the picture. They showed the Miami coach on the sidelines, and he looked like Humpty Hump, Shock G from the Digital Underground. Did you see that picture? My buddy, because he's such a hipster otherwise, that coach, right? The way he fucking dresses and shit, they always talk about him. But look at this. So I'll show you the picture, bro. The way he was like on the sidelines because he was all bundled up. Look. Hold on.
No, they don't know. Yeah, those guys don't know. Yeah, I know who it is, the Miami guy. Yeah, because they're not used to it.
Humpty Hump. It looks like fucking Shock Regional Underground.
Because you can tell he has a tan too going because he just came back from Miami. He's just from my, you know, he lives in Miami.
That's why it's funny, man. I laughed at that. I'm like, that's fucking hilarious because there's Humpty Hump over there on the. Oh, sorry, that's
him. I wanted Miami to go further, but it pissed me off. They lost there, bro.
I know you did. I know. But,
you know. I don't know why I picked the Eagles, bro. I really don't. Honestly, I still can't figure that one out.
The Eagles are one of those teams that fucking people hate them, though.
Yeah, but then, you know, I thought because they kept losing the last few games, I was like, they're going to fucking pull something off. But there's real issues going on in that team.
But here's the thing. I thought the same was going to happen with KC, but he stepped up. But Mahomes is a fucking – I mean, Jalen Hurts is good, no doubt, for sure. But, like, Mahomes, I think, is better personally. But I think they just stepped up to the occasion, and the Eagles didn't, right? Like, that's why I'm surprised you went – I mean, if you got that – if you won with the Eagles, you would have been in first this week. You would have had a strong fucking lead in first with this Eagles
win. No, but even if I picked Tampa, I would have been up there, but not close first. I wouldn't have been close to first.
You're only 2 points behind me, 4 points behind first, which I'm 2 points behind. Right? You're in the running still, right, for this first week. You had a strong showing this first week, right? So, fuck Buffalo, go KC, and trailer, yeah. Fucking.
You know, I don't want KC. I mean, you guys can see whatever you want. I'd rather those guys make enough money on commercials.
I know. Everybody wants to just see them keep winning because of Taylor Swift.
yeah, I know. I was gonna say they're waiting to see Taylor Swift right there at the last fucking at the last second, right?
Yeah. So.
They show her near the end. Oh, and she's showing off some new gear, some new jacket or something that one of the fucking what did it say? One of the wives made. Oh my god, it was just so corny, bro.
Oh man,
but she was in a booth and still freezing.
Job. What's his name? Bob. We always call him
Rob.
Rob, you're a fucking Swiftie. I didn't know that, bud. Jesus, look at this guy. He's excited to see Taylor Swift in the stands.
Bro, you didn't know that was his ringtone when you called.
Is that right? He's got a fucking Taylor Swift song.
Yeah, probably.
I didn't know Rob was 50.
I didn't know either yet. I didn't know. I'm just making it up.
Yeah, he might be. Seems exciting.
He doesn't care, right? I'm surprised. Wow.
Weird.
Okay. I don't know how to answer that. Maybe I should give him a call later. See if he's okay. Yeah, straight up, man. Oh. I'm getting nervous now. Now I'm getting worried.
Speaking of sports, though, did you see that video that came out this past week of the fucking Raptors' new head coach freaking the fuck out? Did you see that clip, bro? That's why
I heard he freaked out, but I've never seen the clip. I don't know what happened.
I got it queued up for you here, bro. You got to watch it. It's fucking hilarious. This guy's eyes are like bulging out of his fucking head. Because they lost to a huge comeback, and he's like he's attributing it to a bunch of bullshit fucking calls that, you know what I mean, like that they shouldn't have won the other team because they came back from like I guess a huge like they were trailing behind them, I think. And
dude, they got 22 calls to 2 against them.
Insane amount. Yeah, listen to what he has to say. I'm not saying he's wrong. He's got a good point in some regards, for sure.
But he got fined for this comment, I think, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, I heard about that. Hold on, let me pull this up. But yo, good for him, man. I think a lot of people were happy about this because, you know, he's taking over for Nick Nurse.
Told him straight up.
But I don't follow follow it too much basketball, but yeah, here we go. Let me just see here.
I thought it was hilarious, bro, when I heard about it on the I've been listening to it on the radio the whole time, right?
Right.
And they keep talking about it. And I kept looking for the clip, but you don't see the I couldn't find the clip itself. I didn't check YouTube.
Yeah. There.
Every time.
There we go. Check this out. I'm letting you hear, hopefully.
Where is she at?
23
throws in that fourth quarter. What could you?
Thank you, Doug. Thank you, Doug. That's outrageous. What happened tonight? This is completely BS. This is shame. Shame for the refs.
Shame.
Allow this. 23 free throws for them, and we get 2 free throws in the fourth quarter. Like how to play the game. I understand respect for all stars and all that, but we have star players on our team as well. How's possible, Scotty?
How possible?
With all-star caliber player in this league, he goes every single time to the rim with force and trying to get to the rim without flopping and not trying to get foul calls. He gets 2 free throws for the whole game. How's that possible? How are you gonna explain that to me? They had to win tonight. If that's the case, just let us know so we don't show up for the game. Just give them a win. But that was not fair tonight. And this is not happening first time for us. Scotty Barnes is going to be all-star. He's going to be the face of this league. And what's happening over here during whole season, I've been holding you back. It's a complete crap.
Yo, this guy fucks, Jay. This guy fucks. Darko Rajakovic.
No.
He's messing around.
There's no explanation. They just come up there, they review what, and they see what they want to see. They don't want to hear us, what we got to say. They don't want to hear the players. They don't just want to.
Because we're from Toronto.
Again, they got 36 free throws, 23 free throws in the fourth quarter. What are we talking about? How are we going to supposed to play?
How are we going to supposed to play?
This is bullshit. Like,
it's happening a lot. But I'm telling our guys, be professional. Keep fighting. Keep going for the next one. But until when? For how long?
I love this fucking guy, man. He's just so mad. Thank you, Doug.
Thank you, Doug.
Thank you, Doug. Just tell us. Next time, we won't show up. You want to win?
He didn't mess around, bro. I was like, wow. I was wondering why they were talking about Scotty Barnes. Kept saying.
He's a star of the league. Thank you, Doug. Thank you, Doug.
But know what it is? He's right, man. It's because they talk about us because we're Canadian, because it's a Canadian team. Yo, and they don't give a fuck about
that
us.
Guy fucks, man. That guy is awesome. Yeah, that guy. I listen. I might have to start watching more basketball with that guy as the head coach now. That guy fucks, man. Honestly, that guy.
Oh, he doesn't mess around, bro. And I didn't even know he was the head coach.
But like you see, you're at the start of the video. It's like he's like his eyes are darting. He's ready like, to go. Oh. He's like he's so. But, mad man, and he's like, "What the fuck was that?" Right?
What I don't understand is, okay, the problem, what he's talking about is, dude, they were ahead, so by getting 23 calls, and the calls were shit, bro. They weren't even barely touching. Like there was guys, like he was saying of the Raptors when I was watching the replays, there was guys of the Raptors going hard and getting, they should have been fouled, bro, right? With the point, right? And still nothing, right?
Some basketball, yeah, really.
Oh yeah, bro. No, that guy, the best is his English sucks, so it's even better, bro. It makes it even more fun to watch.
So much more entertaining, yeah.
Oh my god!
But tell us, next time we just won't even show up to the game.
That's right, but you won't show up. He's right, bro.
You want to win? Like, what's let us know, yeah. Like, what are we doing here? This is bullshit. I just can't wait till like they play like shit one of these days, and he comes out and he's like, he just fucking roasts them. You know, like I can see him doing that. This fucking guy, but no, he's. I think he gained a lot of people's respect for fucking coming out there and saying that.
The players too, bro.
I think
all over the league.
Because there's so many times these guys go in there. And they have these comments after the game, and they just say a bunch of bullshit because they're trying to, like, you know, stay political or whatever in the game. Then you know what I mean? Like, not speak their mind. But he's smoking. Yeah. He outright called them fucking cheaters. And he's like, what are these called? Like, he's like, seriously? What the fuck is this shit? Yeah, I love that, man. Yeah.
No. They were so, some of the calls were just so, yeah, thank you, Doug.
Thank you, Doug. Thank you, Doug.
Those things, and they end up going viral, right? Like, it's crazy because...
Oh, it's the best. I watched that clip 50 times. That's why I'm like, oh, we got to watch this clip on the show. I watched it like fucking 50 times. I couldn't get enough of it. I was like, this guy's awesome. Man. You know, because like I said, I don't really pay attention to basketball that much, but this went viral, like you said, and now he's taking over for Nick Nurse this year, and like, I'm like, that's how you fucking, like, you know what I mean? Like, that's how you make your presence known on this team now as the new coach, right? That was awesome.
Yeah, they don't even listen to us because that's what I mean, because it's the only Canadian team, bro. And that's the whole problem. That's the whole thing, right? So he's trying to set a precedent.
Gets behind his players too. That's what he was saying. He's like, this guy's a star of the league in a few years. Like he's saying he really believes in, like, you know what I mean? Like, that's, I liked that too. He says, like, how dare.
I mean, I don't watch, but I don't know.
Necessarily, but we'll see. But
he's
like,
gonna be that type of player.
No, but listen, he believes it. He clearly believes it though. Like, he's not just like, he actually speaking from, you know what I mean? Like, that's what I mean. I like this guy a lot.
He's got the cojones, bro. And especially with Toronto press, man, you need to, regardless, bro. They fucking eat you alive.
Yes. Thank you, dog.
No, they eat you alive, man. And so he was hoping that that question was brought up.
I think we're going to chop that video up and put it as a sound clip on the show.
Thank you, Doug. Thank you, Doug. Thank you, Doug.
Oh boy! So, yeah.
Oh my God! But he was. It was, to be honest with you, he was passionate about it, bro. He's truly one of those people that is stand behind. You know, he'll stand behind anything. His players, his team, his call.
I'll get to working on it. I'm writing it down right now. Thank you, Doug Cliff.
Yeah. There's a lot of clips we got to get, man. Fuck.
Well, this is all part of it, man. I'm coming this new year correct, man. I'm going to fucking be, you know, I'm trying to put down clips for, that year end of the best of the year 2023 show episode is coming soon, guys. Believe me, it is happening still. Me and Julie actually just came up with the music to put in the background of the video. I pitched a couple ideas out to her. So we've got that worked out. I just got to pull some clips now. And like I said, since I'm not going to be on the show for a while now in the next coming weeks, I'll have the time to kind of put that together. So yeah, that'll be coming soon. Maybe in February we'll have the best of the 2023 video for you guys. And shout out to Julie, because she's the one that really does all the work. Like, I just pull some clips for her, but she's the one that puts it all together. So shout out to her in advance, honestly, because she always does a great job. And that'll be posted on our YouTube channel once that happens.
I can't wait, man.
And later in the year, sometime this year, I want to put together like a super compilation of like the best of 5 years of late night chat type show, you know, a clip show, right? So like,
yeah,
all of our best clips from over the last 5 years of doing it, honestly, because I know that we always do our year end kind of best of type clip video, but I kind of want to do because of the 5 year anniversary, I kind of want to combine like those clip videos together kind of thing and do like a master cut of like all the best moments, right? Some of our best moments were just on the audio show too, don't forget, right? Like, there's some shit that we don't have video for that I think were some great moments, honestly. So
that would have made for some entertaining moments on video too.
Yeah.
So, but
thank you, Doug.
Thank you.
What's this you were telling me the other day? I guess you were talking about it with Rob already too. Is that this fucking rumor about the Corey Perry coming to Toronto? Get the fuck out of here with this shit. Where is this a rumor or what?
It's coming because apparently Marner has a cute mom and stuff like that. And
he's coming for her.
Yeah, he's coming for her, bro. Matthew's mom. Right, he's coming for the mall, bro. But I don't know. I seen a clip one day.
I don't want that piece of garbage on our team. I fucking hate Corey Perry. This is him when he found out that the Leafs are interested. Eh? No. He's coming for his mom. Hey, this is how he's pulling up right here.
Okay, that doesn't sound so bad. Dude, wouldn't you fucking go to a team if he came with somebody? Oh, my God.
No, I can't either. I hope that's not true. I heard that rumor as well. Me and Jay were talking about it, and he mentioned he was talking with you about it. I can't if that guy comes over here. That's enough of this guy. He's been clutch for all the other teams he's played for. Listen, I'm not going to sit here and tell you he hasn't been, because he has. He knows what
he's doing in front of the net.
Yeah, in front of our net. He's the fucking reason.
He also knows what he's doing from behind, apparently, too.
Hey-o! That what Bedard's mom said?
Oh, my God. I wonder if he's going to miss his dad.
No.
He can't even have, he can't nobody to protect him from his jug or help fight it for him now.
I hope that's not the case, though, because the guy apparently, obviously, whether or not you believe that shit about him banging the mom, he's obviously got some shit going on with him. So I don't think we don't need anybody like that over here, even if it's for the playoffs or whatever. Listen, he's been clutching those situations. He's been a fucking thorn in our ass for a while now. Don't get me wrong. He's the one that reason
any team he's played in the finals, bro.
Got the fucking winning goal that got you guys into the next round. I think it was him, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, right? Or was that Tampa Bay?
I think it might have been.
Tampa Bay. It was one of those, because he bounced around. He's bounced around like three fucking teams the last few years, right?
Yeah, those teams have made it to the finals too.
Yeah, yeah.
Pretty much.
I don't know. I just hope not.
I don't know. You guys need the goalie. Fuck Corey Perry.
I know. But yeah, because when he was with Tampa, it was the year they didn't win. You're right. And then Montreal, same thing, right, in the finals.
He's trying to win a cup because he wants to get a cup before he probably bounces and says, I'm out again. But, I mean.
Listen, he was a good contribution to those teams. I'm not going to hold that against him. He was. He kind of worked his way into those teams, and he fit well, and he did. He was part of that run with them, but I have no respect for the guy, because I've learned to hate him over the last couple of times we lost to the teams he's been a part of. We lost to him. He was part of.
I think I got some more respect now that he was banging the moms and the wives. I think I gained a little bit more respect than when he plays hockey, right?
Yeah.
Because at least we know he's still getting what he wants or whatever, right? But I mean, that's kind of fucked up if that's the case. Anyways, I mean, who knows, bro? It could be anything. Right, but I mean, fingers are pointing that way anyway, so I might as well point mine there too. Join the herd, right? Because if he's still getting some at his age, there's still luck for me, bro. I mean, I'm not making $1 million a year at least. That's all he gets signed for nowadays, anyways. He doesn't get signed for anything crazy, so it's not
He's close to retirement, I would think, at this point, right? I mean,
he's an easy pickup for any team, to be honest with you.
Yeah, because where he started his career over in Anaheim, right? Years ago, I remember. I remember when he came on the scene, and then he didn't really pan out, I think. But the way I think people were expecting him to, but yet in his later years, he has been contributing quite a bit, in the playoffs.
Because it's experience, right?
Yeah. And if he stays healthy, yeah, for sure. No, it's.
It probably works. He has to probably work twice as hard, if not, three times as hard to fucking stay in shape and stay, like the young guys. But yeah, man.